I'm Alfredo Aragon.
I'm Steven.
I'm Kendrick.
And today, for our experiment, we're going to be shooting a potato at a suspended mass and using the height at which it swings to calculate the potato's velocity. So our experiment modeled that similar to a ballistics pendulum, where we had to measure the potato's initial mass as well as the initial mass of the object we were firing it at.
These are some of the measurements that we got from our project. We ended up measuring the potato out to be 0.228 kilograms. We measured our target, figured out that it was 9.9 kilograms, and then looking at the change in vertical height between impact and the apex of the swing of our ballistics pendulum after it got hit by the potato, we found that the change in height was 4 inches, which in meters is 0.102 meters. We figured out that we're going to need to use the energy lens and the momentum lens to be able to figure the speed of the potato out. The reason being is you can find the energy of the combined potato and target using the change in height that we got from the video. And then that potential energy can be used to find the kinetic energy of the two combined, which then can be used to find the velocity of the two combined. Which then, if you look at the momentum lens and the fact in the law of conservation of momentum, you can, using the equation m1 v1 equals m2 v2, the mass of the potato, the mass of them combined, and the velocity of them combined, you can then also solve for the velocity of them combined.
So to find the final velocity after the collision, we're using the energy lens. Now we know that potential energy equals the mass times the force of gravity times the change in height. And we do know the change in height, which we measured in the video. So to solve for this, we're going to have the mass times gravity, which we all know is 10 meters per second squared, and then height, which is equal to 0.102 meters in this case. And we're gonna use this to solve for the velocity. So we can set the final potential energy at the apex equal to the kinetic energy right at the impact. So we're gonna set this equal to 1/2 mv squared. And you'll see here, the mass is unimportant because those are going to cancel. And when we solve for the final velocity, we end up with 1.417 meters per second. So now that we've solved for the velocity of the system after the collision, we can solve for the velocity of the potato before the collision using the conservation of momentum. Now you may be asking yourself, why didn't we just set the kinetic energy of the system after the collision equal to the kinetic energy of the potato before the collision? Well, a lot of energy was actually lost to heat on the impact, which is why momentum is always conserved in the collision, so we're going to use momentum here. So if we just plug in the values, the mass of the potato is 0.228 kilograms. Times its velocity, that would be the momentum, equals the mass and the velocity of the system after the collision. The mass of the system is going to be the potato plus the target, so we're going to get 0.228 kilograms plus 0.9.9 kilograms, all times the final velocity, which we just solved for, which is 1.417 meters per second. And so all we gotta do is divide out the 0.228 here. Don't forget temperature units, and you'll find that we end up with, once the mass cancels, I know what you're thinking. Great job, guys. That's a really accurate number. I can't believe you did that. Now we know the exact speed that your potato comes out of your can. Well, unfortunately, it doesn't exactly work like that. There are actually several sources of error during your calculation that we just couldn't make up for. So this is just a rough estimate of how fast the potato is actually going.
So some of the errors that we have in our calculations, simply because of the tools that we have and other things like that, mean that as close as this number is, it isn't exact. So some of the really obvious ones to note is in the video you can see that when we shoot it, the string holding our target up, actually bounces and compresses and stretches a little bit. So our height difference of 0.102 meters, that's not exact, but it's as close as we could get. Again, just because we don't have a way of measuring the exact change in height. The other issue, or another issue, is that our mass, the way we calculated our mass was if the potato and the target combined and stayed together entirely, which if you look at the video again, you can see that the potato actually splatters, and some of it sticks, some of it doesn't. We have no way of actually calculating how much does. Another source of error for our equation is the difference between the potential energy and the kinetic energy. Because a lot of the kinetic energy of the potato went into rotational energy of the target, because if you look at the target in the video, you can see that it's spinning fairly rapidly. It means that just makes our calculations not as accurate.
So, just one more source of error before we wrap this all up. Now, when the potato hit the target, we realized it didn't just stick in the target. So that changes both the final mass of the system afterwards, but also the fact that when the potato hit it, it exploded and chunks of potato went in all kinds of different directions. Some of them went backwards, making this an elastic collision, but some of them went to the side, like all over the place. So if you wanted to find the actual final momentum to solve for the initial momentum of the potato, you'd have to add up all the vectors of every chunk of potato that flew off, find their mass and velocity, sum them all up, and you'd have the total momentum that was in the system. So again, our number that we found for the velocity, it's not completely accurate, but it's the best we can do, and we hope you enjoyed our video today.